certainly responded to Remy Ma, and yeah, it's been 2 weeks right now. Good God, yeah. But she came out with a three pack. You know, there are three songs against her, and I heard that I see right now that Drake and Lil Wayne is on some of them. And I heard that she even, you know, going after Safari and Meek Mill. So let's check it out, man. There's three songs, man. The first one I'm going to check out is featuring Lil Wayne and Drake. Let go. I got my brisk. Man, we're going to sit back and listen to all these joints, man. So let's check it out, man. Here we go. Turn this up. I'm literally sipping my tea. Literally. All right, nice beat. Well, it's a great business move. Of course, she got Lil Wayne and Drake. She's gonna make a hit. So, if it don't be a good track, this track, it's gonna be a hit. Okay, now I might be pausing it and stuff like that. I might chop this video up because I don't know, man. I don't want to copyright and all that stuff because, you know, Nicki Minaj, you know, she might, you know, want her money for these tracks. So I'm going to chop it up or pause it, y'all. So sorry about that. Okay, with the singing and stuff like that, man, I don't know, man. I guess I wanted, like, just straight bars, but I don't know, man. I guess I with Nicki Minaj now, you're going to have to get what you get, man. So the first kind of line was okay. Let's get back into it. You can't beat Pablo if your work ain't selling. Wait. What the fuck is this bitch in Helen? Okay, now that is going against that that album that kind of flopped, man. Fat Joe and Remy Ma, was it Plomo, whatever it's called, Blood and Bullets, whatever. So let's get back into that. I would have helped you out that pitch you fell in. I am the generous queen. Ask Miss Ellen. Tried to drop another one. You was itching to scratch. Oh, shit. Wait a minute. Okay, so generous. Like Ellen DeGeneres. Okay. That little flew over my head, man. You know, it's early in the morning, y'all. I'm doing this. Okay, let's go. She going after, you know, going after the kids. I mean, hey, Remy went after her brother and stuff like that, so of course they had to go after kids, man. Back the pack, oh, you mean back the whack, back the pack. Me and Trissy laughed at that. They say numbers don't matter, but when they discussing the kings, they turn around and say LeBron ain't got six rings. I never signed a 360 with you, well done. That's why Jane Claire's verse for your album. Sinead, you a fraud committing perjury. I got before and after pictures of your surgery. Well, he got four rings. What the heck is she talking about? Yeah, LeBron just got, you know, two rings with the Heat and two rings. I mean, hold on. He got three rings. I'm talking about four rings. He got just three. What the hell is she talking about? Maybe I got to listen to that, what the hell she said, but... He got three rings. Unless there's something else she said with adding with rings, I don't know. Anyway, I meant to say something about Remy Ma too, man. She was talking about Belushi and Ghostbusters. John Belushi and Jim Belushi. None of them Belushis was in Ghostbusters, okay? They had Acro within it and all that stuff. But let's keep on going, y'all. Wow.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for Travis Scott in the background. Yeah. All right, let me hear Wayne and Drizzy now. Let's see what the hell they got to say. Cause they really got it done too. That wasn't, I don't know, man. That wasn't that direct, was it? Just like, I guess they just talk about numbers and stuff. Let's go. All right, Weezy. Yeah, they ain't going at her. I thought they were going to say at least say something, but it's like, I guess they keep on calling her fraud, I guess. So, yeah. And that's it. Okay. Well, there you go, man. They got a hit. They got a hit, right? I don't know about going back at Remy. Yeah. Remy just demolished, you know, everybody with that one, man. So even if she came with like a hot or crazy one, man, it still would have been, I don't think, touch that shit, man. So let's go on to the next one, man. Let's go on to Nicki Minaj's Changed It. This is just featuring Lil Wayne. Okay, is this gonna be the, like the same old stuff? It's auto-tune singing, just trying to make a hit, I guess. Trying to get money off it, I guess. I don't know, man. It got me thinking too, man, that all this is planned too, even with Remy, man. I mean, this is a thought, man, that it has happened before, man, with people, rappers saying, oh, yeah, I'm gonna make this shot, you make this, and do this, and do that, and, yeah, we're gonna get this dough, man. You know, so it is possible, man. It is possible. Okay, Thank you, Nikki, for that. it's just the same bouncy as. Come on, Nick. I wanted something harder, man. Some New York shit, man. Remy came out with New York shit, you know, with the Nas beat and all that stuff. I wanted some hard shit, man. Not no. I mean, come on. I don't know, man.
Hey,
hey,
you can't do that.
Hey, man, I'm trying to get out here. Okay, so I guess she's saying that she's just like the same type of thing, which is true. I mean, but that's Remy, man. Remy, that's her thing. That's her flow. That's her style. You know, if she changes and be something else, then she would be a fraud and stuff like that, man. Yeah. Let's go. Remy, I like Remy, man. I like her authentic type stuff, that New York kind of flow and rap and stuff. Okay, this is okay. Just naming things they do. All right, man. Let me go to it. If it's another Nicki verse or something up, man. Let me see, man. Hold on to me. Nope. All right, so that was number two, man. Now let's go to "Regret in Your Tears," man. This is supposed to be, you know, going after Safari and Meek Mill. So let's go. Last one. So what is it, like a song? Of course, it's gotta be a reggae type song. Did the trap joint, now you gotta do a reggae joint. Okay, it's just typical, like a reggae joint, and I guess she just, you know, singing out her emotions and stuff like that. Well, when Nicki does the reggae joints, man, I gotta admit, she really kills. I like how her flow when she does reggae joints and stuff like that, 'cause she has that cadence and stuff like that to really do it. So, but where like, I wanted like if it was gonna be a reggae joint, I wanted to like a real joint, like a like real kind of gangster reggae type shit, man, like old school type. But I don't know. And like that song with what's the girl name, man? Stefflon Don. What's the song? 16 shots. Da, 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 da. I want a shit like that, man. I guess she came out with that. She's like, damn, I can't come out with no 16 shots. She already came out with a joint like that, so I don't know. All right, man. All right, that's enough, man. I heard him, man, and that's as good as Nicki gonna get, man. I mean, just everybody gonna get from Nicki. I already knew it, man. And I knew that she was gonna put Lil Wayne and Drake on it and stuff like that. I already knew everything she was gonna do, man. I knew she was gonna make a singy song about them two, Meek and Safari, and I knew all this stuff, man. I knew it. It'd probably be a hit, man. Some of these, probably all of them be probably be all on the radio and shit. But yeah, y'all tell me what you thought about the joints, coming back at Remy and Meek and Safari and stuff like that. If you like my reaction to them, hit the like button, comment, subscribe, and share, y'all. I give it about, I don't know, maybe a 5, 6 or something like that, man. All right, until next time, y'all, I'm out.